So, Jeff, did you hurt your foot because you tripped over yourself after you saw a space Latino?
Negative.
Hi.
Space Latino.
I'm not even sure I know what a space Latino is anymore.
My name is Tommy, and I live in this house.
He does.
And I would like to welcome you after 2 weeks, no, 3 weeks, of separation from the last part. There's no apologies needed because there was an injury, and then an injury, and then my heart injury. So, we are back.
Tommy has never changed. All these years have known him.
He hasn't.
Sometimes it makes me
my funny. Heart. The injuries are about you, but it's about me.
I'm such an asshole. I would like to welcome you back to the lovely world of Great Britain, because you guys are not at Hogwarts at the beginning of this session.
That's right.
Because you guys were in Ravenclaw Tower, and with Professor Flitwick, you took down a greater hidebehind, more monstrous and faster and more deadly than the predecessor. You saved a gaggle of Ravenclaws, including your friend, Sarah Winchester, who Jenny didn't like, but your character's supposed to, but whatever.
I was suspicious of her. No, I think my character did like her. It was just me that was iffy.
But being a jerk.
You guys were told at the end that Hogwarts was closing for 1 month. In order to make sure that the castle was actually secure and try to find why, how... Jeff's mask broke. Why,
this is
how,
itchy as F. Oh my god.
You were wearing it inside out.
I flipped it inside out intentionally because the other side was itchier!
I have an extra one. It might smell a bit like my purse.
I can hold a napkin over my nose.
I'm half vaccinated, so.
I am all vaccinated.
Yes. I'm glad.
I'm not vaccinated at all.
Well,
unfortunately.
You have the most to lose. Anyway,
we can't say that. We have to refer to it as the Backstreet Boys reunion tour.
Oh man!
All right.
I would like to point out also that you guys were told that at the end of last session, Sarah Winchester would not be returning to Hogwarts. She was returning home to the States.
That was correct.
And she would always house a fear of the dark and the unknown and things that she cannot see, which she knows exists now, such as things that can turn invisible, ghosts, poltergeists, spirits, whatever. She is afraid of them. And there's not much that you can really do for her at this point because she is no longer coming back into your lives.
So sad.
Now, that being said, I'm going to actually, fittingly, fast forward your character's time by 3 weeks, as this campaign has also fast forwarded 3 weeks.
Mm.
Just to make it easy. Because whatever amount you guys recall kind of matches what your characters feel. Because after 3 weeks of being away from Hogwarts and away from teachers and away from each other, you guys also start to wonder, huh, you know I fought those monsters. I know that, like, I was in scary situations. I even fought Death Eaters, for God's sake. But, like, it sort of feels like a dream. And that's the illusion of time and the separation of the stimulus. Psychology. So, you guys are dealing with a bit of separation. Basically, just settings are different, and therefore your beliefs are slightly altered or needing to fit into new parameters. Now, Franz has been interacting with you. Because he lives, like, right there. You can look out your window and sing a little Swedish jaunty, and he'll go,
"Aah." I was just about to joke about, like, waving at the window.
Yeah.
Or waving through the window.
And he's getting dressed, and he's like, "Oh,
take some of it off.
You weren't supposed to see
him. Oh, my. Let me just put this on the ground and bend over to get it.
Oops.
Bend and snap.
Cody.
Good boy.
For those of you listening, Cody's been kind of a bad boy today. All right.
Cody is a dog also, by the way.
Cody is a dog, not our servant.
There was just one session where I was talking for him when he came over here. I was like, oh, Dad, I love you. I was like, what the heck? It's not really realistic. I'm like, that must be what I'm doing.
It must have been Cody, yeah. I didn't hear him.
My favorite,
Peter, I love you so much.
My favorite thing from this campaign so far is when I just broke into the Quidditch bit. When I was talking about the Quidditch squabbles and yada yada. And I just spouted out random rhyming gibberish.
It was
really great. You were like, when the Dr. Seuss is this? It was so fucking funny. Oh my god.
That's timestamped too.
The quaffling quaffers quaffed.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Quaffed
the beach of waffle quaffles. Yes. Alright.
And then let's not. Oh, sorry, go ahead.
Aaron.
Oh,
that's right, yes.
You.
That's me.
Have been at home with Dad number two and Dad B. And they have been farming with you. You've been gathering the oats for the oat monster, and you've been gathering the eggs from the dragons, and you've been getting the salamanders out of the dirt pile because they need to go burn things. You've been doing a lot of the things that are listed in that book right next to you, actually, to take care of your friends. Also, your bow truckle friends missed you, so they've been kind of swarming you while you fall asleep. Anyway, you have been sort of out of touch with people because Sarah was your main contact. Chauncey and you don't really exchange owls.
No.
And then these two have been, like, I don't know, making out in Sweden or something? You're not quite sure. But let it be known that I am a DM who is worthy of bringing both of you together through story.
Excellent.
Because both of you somehow simultaneously plan to go to Diagon Alley on the same day.
Excellent.
Isn't that amazing? Excellent. How just fate works?
I'm not a big fan of Diagon Alley. I'd probably go somewhere else.
Okay. Go to Nocturne Alley.
Yeah.
Okay.
Excellent.
I play the, like, Song of Stones.
John wants
or whatever.
Ice cream really
song
bad.
Of, song,
don't
song
you,
of,
John?
Song of Banff.
The sun song to change the time of day. There we go. That's what I was trying to think of.
Great.
Because it turned to Nocturne. Anyway.
Great. You. Get the floor, each of you now, to kind of tell me what would your characters be thinking, considering that you have now taken down two dangerous, murderous beasts. You've been away from school for 3 weeks. The war is still going on. A friend of yours is not coming back. And you haven't seen each other. And this is your OWL year, which, by the way, you were given Chromebooks to do homework at home.
Of course. Nice. So
that's a lot.
My character,
but it will help you get into the mindset.
And it's something that I always did wonder about the characters in the main books that we love so much. Like, how what was going through their mind after all this crap would happen at the school year and they'd have summer break.
I like relationships and stuff.
Knowing Hermione, it was I gotta keep supporting my friends while they kind of use me for my brain. Sorry.
Get lost in a book. Go ahead,
Beth.
Gregory?
Gregory is still freaking out about the fact that my parents didn't send the howler.
Oh, yeah. So you've been staring in front of a mirror every once in a while, just staring like, who did it? And your mom will come in and go, honey, seriously. Honey. The mirror's cracked. You've been... You're looking at a fragmented form of yourself.
I'm like, ooh. Going crazy.
You intentionally keep the lights off?
What in the Lovecraft's going on in here?
Lord Cthulhu.
Yes. All right. Dude, wouldn't it be great if Cthulhu was, like, actually, like, Dr. Sleepers? Anyway, appendages. That's all that needs to be said. The noodliness. Yeah, I mean, I'm like, freaking out about the howler, because it's, like, someone had to have sent it that was, like, close enough to me to know about, like, mine and Franz's, like, connection and wording it in such a way that, like, would be, you know, relatable to, like, how, like, my parents would sound.
Mm-hmm.
And also so soon. like so soon after what had happened. Like that's nuts to me.
Give me a cutting check.
Ha! Ha! Blah! Three.
Give me one more.
Nah. One.
So I'm going to say that your memory of that day is becoming warped to the point where you don't really remember the conversations you had around it or the specific details to really help you pick out clues to figure out who could have sent this to you. So really, like, you've been thinking about it so much, it's become a detriment to you.
That's fair. Jeff has ideas, but not sure. Gregory. So there's that. I also feel like, in terms of my placement in Gryffindor, I feel a little bit more, like, sound in my placement, having been on the forefront of, like, fighting those creatures. So I'm probably going to feel a lot closer to my Gryffindor pals when I go back, instead of hanging out at the Hufflepuff table all the time. But I'm still going to hang out at the Hufflepuff table all the time, so I'm in like this weird limbo there. But I don't think the battles are weighing on me as much as the howler and like what to eat next.
very important.
So I'm probably looking for some nice eateries while I'm in Diagon Alley with Aaron.
John loves Florian Fontescue's ice cream parlor.
Jenny, what would your character be doing?
Oh man, baby. But as for me, I don't know. I pictured her as being kind of tough.
Do you guys want forks or no?
I will have to take a fork, please. Yes.
Cameron's like, please.
This looks...
Sorry about the mess.
This is a thick boy right here.
Looks delicious.
Now we're going to make all of our listeners, all three of my listeners, super jealous at the sound of us eating
lemon
moist,
cake.
Iced lemon cake.
Anyway, like, I pictured Aaron kind of hiding any serious emotions. Like, she's kind of like a tough person, but also, like, has almost an irreverent sense of humor, like everything's silly and a joke. Instead of, like, really thinking about what happened or taking things seriously. She's really missed people, though, I think. Gregory and...
So, yeah, that leads me to a question. Would you guys send owls to each other, or probably not? Knowing who your characters are, like, is out forthcoming, or...
I probably would. Probably want to check in. And I especially want to check in with Franz. They seem a little rattled.
Constantly.
It's like, I knew he'd be fine, because you'd be watching out for
him. Is Franz with us at Diagon Alley?
He will be, yeah.
And she feels bad about Sarah, too.
Yeah.
Jenny feels bad about Sarah, too.
Jeff feels bad about Sarah. I don't think Gregory feels bad.
I had this dumb thing in my mind that she was letting the high behinds in or something. I have no idea why.
Yeah, maybe we shouldn't assume that she's the victim in this scenario. Maybe she left. Maybe she left Hogwarts because she's a tool.
Just like that one Slytherin guy, whatever his name was, that died in Harry Potter.
Oh, that was so sad. That was dark. Oh man.
Yeah, fucking dark.
Hamish.
What was his name?
No.
Ham sandwich.
Hey, Botham.
It was Haytham.
Haytham. God, I was kidding there.
Ah, yes, Haytham.
Haymitch.
It was so sad that he killed... Who was it?
was it Matthias?
Matthias. Matthias.
Malachite.
Tobias.
Just look at me like... You bastard.
Sheev.
I am the Senate.
I am the Senate.
We're going to get absolutely nothing done this session.
Not at all.
We're eating cake. We're recounting previous episodes.
So, I'll take the reins. You guys are told by your individual parents, hey, Gregory, I have to go to Gringotts tomorrow. Do you want to come with me? Possibly bring Franz and we can go by the pillow store. I don't know.
Gringotts, isn't that the bank?
My wizard pillow, huh?
Dude, I need some funds, bro. Yeah, let's go.
Gregory, this is the family funds. We're just going to give you your savings. You have a future to look
forward to. You call your mom, bro.
Dude, I've got... Let's see here.
This is delicious cake.
I have exactly zero money.
So I have a galleon, a sickle,
I would like to pull some comfort funds out of my savings, if you wouldn't mind, Mummy.
I'm your father, actually. But
I
said father. You just start saying, Mother, right to your dad's bearded face.
It was James Foster. She was like, you called your mom, bro.
She's playing it safe because she has two dads in this game. Like, don't touch your dad that way. Or your dad.
So everyone's a dad.
I'm also not an auditory learner at all. So a lot of it flies out my other ear. All
right. You.
But I try so hard.
Darling gal. Your fathers sit you down.
Oh,
at the breakfast table one morning and say, dear heart, we can tell that there is something holding you. Either it be fear or hesitation or doubt, or perhaps you're just becoming a woman. We don't know. But we do want to say we are here for you. And we need you to do something for yourself, but also for us. We're out of ice cream.
Oh! Alright.
So we need you to go get some more.
Excellent.
Here's some funds.
Yay!
There are temporary family funds in a small little pouch for you.
Should I add them to my thing?
I would add them as a temporary little pouch.
You ever try salted caramel?
As a small little pouch, if you want to open it and possibly add it to your own funds, you may, but it's up to you.
Yes, I will add it to my own funds.
There are exactly 25 canuts.
Ah, excellent. Okay. Thank you. I thank them profusely.
So you have been sent to Diagon Alley on your own. Your fathers will not escort you. You have been told your father will escort you to Gringotts for a family visit with Franz to get funds, not necessarily for you, and maybe take you to your favorite store. The one that you loved when you were young.
The creamery?
The pillow store.
Big pardon.
Don't you remember when you were five?
You
loved bouncing on the rubbery pillows, and you were like, woo-hoo-hoo, and it was a whole... Do you not do that anymore?
I was five!
Do you not do that anymore?
I mean, I like bouncing. It's in my nature. I'm Swedish.
Then you love...
I missed that.
Oh, my God. You'll hear it back in the recording.
Yeah. It's in my nature.
Timestamp.
Okay. Whatever this recording is at. 18 minutes. All right, cool.
Do I use the flu network?
Actually, yes. That's what I was going to say, is that they would give you a small little sack and say, buy a bit more flu powder while you're at it. Why don't you? And he hands you two sickles. He's like, get like another, like a bag.
Yes, daddy.
I'm dad number two. All right.
Dad number two.
Daughter A.
Daughter A.
Those names. Or is this dad one and two?
No,
dad
them.
Two and dad B.
Oh, right.
Come on.
I took
equality. All right. On October 24th, exactly 1 week before Halloween, and a few days before you are meant to return to Hogwarts, you are both arriving in Diagon Alley. You went via bus because you live in the city proper.
Okay.
And you arrived through the Leaky Cauldron.
Excellent.
And you were just like, oh good, I can try some ale. And your father's like, no. Aww. And you're like, but it's for a recipe. And he's like, oh no. He grabs both of you by your necks, takes you to... takes you by the stone wall, taps the five stones, and spiral opens into an archway, and you're like, wow. So what was the original design of this wall that J.K. Rowling thought of? I got to draw it for you. Anyway, you,
Pidgey, we only see it one time,
arrive in a bonfire of sorts that is set off to one of the alleyways within the alleyway that is like a free roaming flu network bonfire that constantly exists for people who want to use the flu network to get to Diagon Alley. This is a real thing, by the way. You can look it up. There is like just a... Actually reminds me of Salem Witch Trials, the whole... Like, a witch was burned at the pyre.
Yeah.
That whole, like, bundle underneath her, that's what it looks like.
Oh, right. Bonfire. Okay.
Yeah.
So where Harry was supposed to go in the second book, but instead he went into the scary store.
Yes. So
Morgan
you...
and Bex.
You clearly said...
Diagon Alley.
Roll a d20.
I have very good memories. Very good recalling, memory. Like, Harry Potter store information.
That was done in the books.
I read it every other year, and I do like to watch the movies a lot, although I haven't watched them in a while. Ooh, 19.
You are so confident and have no doubt in your mind that you are heading to Diagon Alley, that you're just like, Diagon Alley-o. And you just skip right into the green flames, and you twirl, and you arrive.
At Fiagon Galley.
Oh, shit! Oh, gosh. This past year, Rona time, though, my friend Jake got me really into that Wizards Unite game, which is like Pokemon Go, Harry Potter.
Yeah,
so I also do that all the time. Crowd.
I really wanted to like it. It was like right before COVID. Sorry. Right before herpes. And so I didn't really...
Herpes complex outbreak.
I didn't get into it as much. Anyway.
Now I can't monetize my 3 viewers. Damn it.
I'll play the Skyrim soundtrack.
Yeah, there you go.
I'll get it back. All right.
My
you guys arrive
video game
25 minutes into recording. And you both kind of come to a crossroads of sorts because you're coming out of the mini hallway, our alleyway. You are coming straight down Diagon Alley towards Gringotts, which is at the end. Okay. So you guys naturally go, ugh.
Oh.
Hi.
Hey. It's nice to commune with you via face instead of owl.
It is. How are you?
Good.
How's Franz? Is he there?
I'm right here.
Oh, hi, Franz.
Hello.
He's bouncy, just like me.
I've really gained weight. I've been stress eating.
Oh, you know.
I've been sending him desserts every day.
He's been making me donuts.
Excellent.
They're grand.
I pictured John jumping up on both of you and giving you licks and stuff.
I need you to stop filling mine with lard, however.
Why do you sound like James Corden?
They're hurting my
actually,
lard.
Lard.
I actually don't know what James Corden sounds like, but I'll take that as a compliment.
It's pretty close to what you're doing. Did someone confuse me for James Corden at the casino once when I had much shorter hair.
Do not look like that.
And I was like,
You were doing an impression, maybe.
Like, I can see it, but
I was like,
no.
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 I'm not even in, like, an English accent. I'm like, what the crap? Anyway.
Yeah, what the hell, customer? Okay.
It was...
John came with you?
Yes.
Okay.
Absolutely.
Give me a retroactive D20 for the flu network with a cat.
He needs his damn ice cream. 13.
You manage to hold on to him as you skippity-dee through the green flames, arriving in Fiagon Galley.
Excellent.
And
the
you
evil parallel universe of Diagon.
And you admire the fact that Johnny Boy is not yowling at all. You're like, oh, it must be safe here. Thank Gord.
You know, yeah. Her parents letting her go unescorted in wartime is interesting.
You do happen to know exactly...
But I'm an adult.
...where the ice cream parlor is situated, which is about one store down towards Gringotts. You can see Gringotts right there. Your father has not been introduced to your friend. But who needs nanas?
What?
Hello, father.
Hello,
father.
David Tennant. Creepo.
Tommy.
Dude.
I would like to introduce myself to Gregory's father.
Mr. Wolstenholme.
Oh, yes, Mr. Wolstenholme.
It's Wolstenholme.
Oh, sorry. It's not German. Right, right. Wolstenholme.
It is great to meet you, Aaron. We're on our way to Gringotts. Do you need money?
No, but I'll come along.
My dad's a condescending prick.
Do you need money?
I picture her looking like him, like Professor Sprout. Like, she's got dirt on her nose constantly. Yeah. Who knows what? And, like, maybe...
What are these things hanging up my chest?
No, like, wizarding coveralls, flannels. You know, she probably looks like she could use a bath a lot because of the outside animal working thing.
She's got huge... Tracks of lands.
Tracks of lands.
Alright.
No, I didn't picture her with huge tracts of land.
Stop. Daddy.
Jenny does, though.
Maybe go by the ice cream parlor before Gringotts.
That, yes, but I have to bring some back to my parents. I don't want it to melt, so.
Oh. Okay, I guess we can go last.
Yeah.
Sadness.
Would you rather go to the ice cream parlor instead of your favorite pillow shop? Do you remember when we used to call you Pillow when you were a baby?
My brothers are obsessed.
When you were so young that you were like a little squishy pillow. Give me an embarrassment check to see if you're mortified in front of your friends.
Five.
You're pretty embarrassed, yeah. You're pretty like dad. Shut up.
I'm a teenage dad. Dog. Let's go to Gringotts first, I guess.
All right, sounds good.
Franz takes your hand as you are strolling down the cobblestone street.
What's wrong with that?
Okay, I'm totally kidding. Okay. I let him take my hand. It's hilarious.
God, this is probably the '80s or whatever. So.
Oh, it's the '80s. So like. Freddie Mercury's still alive. That's great.
He's like the biggest wizard of the time.
Rest in peace.
All right, you guys make your way down the surprisingly busy alleyway of Diagon Alley. Mm. I say surprisingly because this is still wartime.
Yeah.
So you are used to last summer when you were here getting your books and whatnot. Mm. You didn't really see anybody. Not even like new students getting their wands from Ollivander's or people going to Dervish and Bangs or whatever. You guys don't even see... You didn't see many people, but now you do. A little strange. But, whatever. Hello, Cody emerged.
He's been over here.
Hi.
Just kind of looking at us like...
He's been waiting for you to acknowledge
him. I'm glad he
waited.
I'm going to give you attention now, Cody.
Is the hardest part.
You're going to receive my attention and enjoy it. Are you enjoying it? Good.
That is good, good boy.
This is good.
He is middle-aged dog now. Look at his gray hair.
Yeah. Mm. He has gray hairs. And he's a big, stoopy Cody boy.
Stewie hooey hooey.
Stoopy Cody boy. Okay, I'm going to stop petting you now.
Good luck.
And you're going to enjoy it.
I love not being pet.
Good job.
Alright. As you guys are making your way towards Gringotts, and the gigantic white marble building in front of you that kind of goes out like a V, kind of like that building in New York that I can never remember the name of. You guys hear a commotion. Like, loud commotion.
The Vatican?
No, like loud commotion.
In New York City?
Loud commotion.
This is America!
America.
And you look towards the doors, and you see Briar Kane.
What?
Your friend who's not a friend.
Why? Okay.
Your friend who's not a
Sorry,
friend.
Sorry, my dumb brain's like, that's
Why
a
Why does stuff keep
Perry
happening
Blum?
To Briar? I'm so sad.
Okay. Maybe it's because he's a Slytherin. Maybe because he's misunderstood.
I like
Maybe
science.
Because of who his parents are.
Maybe it's Maybelline.
Maybe it's Maybelline.
Mm. Maybe it's because he wants Maybe to end a war in, like, a very different and, like, maybe even, like, altruistic way. But it was kind of vague when he was talking about it, so I don't know if it's that or if it's just completely against the grand rebellion on his part. Like, he's some kind of, like, rogue wizard. Anyway, keep going.
But what's a little sad is that this time he's upset at two goblins who seem just about done with him.
Oh no.
And he's not yelling, but he's definitely upset that there seems to have been something done about his account.
Uh-oh.
And they keep telling him, you emptied your account earlier today.
Is that the real Briar King?
You signed the paperwork to close out your account.
Uh-oh. Not good.
There is nothing here for you. If you would like to open an account, we can help you. But that would be very weird. Because you closed your account. Because you were here earlier. And you signed the paperwork.
To close it.
To close it.
And liquidate it.
I'm gonna go.
We overhear all of this.
Yeah. And your father is even like, that poor boy. He must be losing his mind. Forgetting what he's done.
That's the Slytherin chap that I must have told you about within the 3 weeks that we were on vacation. Right.
He looks very well dressed for a Slytherin son.
Well, he comes from prestigious Death Eaters.
What?
Nothing.
This is the friend that you told me was the sort of friend, but not really a friend?
Yeah.
You're associating with the Death Eater boy?
No, he's not one.
It's complicated.
So you're undercover trying to bring him down?
The Gryffindor side of me agrees with that, yes, very much. But the Hufflepuff side of me is like, he's cool and he's helped us in battle before and he's intriguing and I believe him when he wants to, or when he tells me that he wants to end the war and, you know, not be associated with his Death Eater background and stuff.
Gregory?
Yes?
You look over and Briar's walking towards you. I thought I heard you talking.
We were talking about you.
Hi.
I'm not sure if I should be offended or not.
Definitely don't be offended. I was defending you. So don't be offended. Be grateful of the defending.
That's right.
Just be fended.
Straight up fended, yo. Fended.
I would be fended.
I would rather be befriended. Anyway.
Oh. He wants to be friends.
Fran says, hi, we haven't really met. I'm Franz Hagrid, and you are Briar King?
That is a cool name, it's like...
And Briar says, yes, I'm Briar King, and you must be Franz Hagrid. And I don't believe we have met, but it's great to meet you. I hear you are great friends with these two saviors of magical...
Real quick, I believe Franz has seen Briar in passing.
In passing, not met.
Got it. Okay.
They have not actually spoken to each other.
Want to clear that up? Cool.
I ask him how he's doing.
I'm quite livid. Apparently, my entire savings has been stolen, and they don't believe me. So, if you could... Actually, no, there's no way to save me from this one this time, because my parents are in Azkaban, and they cannot save me from a life of poverty away from them, and I have no money to really get me anything that I need to try and stop the war.
Oh,
so,
no.
If... you could not make life harder. That would be great.
How's your credit line?
I mean, I'll...
I'm 16.
I'll try.
No.
How do you think that happened? Do you have any...
I have several theories.
Okay.
Because I'm Briar Kane. However...
Is Polyjuice Potion one of your theories?
Yes. However...
That's what I was thinking.
Yes. However... I'll write you an owl. Talk about this later.
Oh, wait. Didn't we...
I wish I had more money to lend
didn't
him.
A Polyjuice potion...
There is an apothecary, a
book or something when we were at Hogwarts and someone was, like, reading it. Maybe it was that person. It was just coincidence. I'm overthinking.
Maybe you should be re-listening to your past recordings.
Well, yes, no, that does ring a bell. Was that when we were in the library?
And I want to say it was the library.
That really awkward, oh god, I think we're probably not allowed in the library ever again.
We could sneak in.
There? No, that does ring a bell. I'm sorry.
It's okay.
Well, you've been great helps. So I really appreciate it. I'll write both of you owls. If I can afford paper.
I think I got a little pouch from my parents if I had anything else. Like, wait, do I have an account?
Yeah.
Oh, cool. Can I access it myself?
Yes.
Oh, all right. I would like to do that to give him some money.
You grab Briar by the wrist and say, come with me, pretty boy. And the five of you enter.
And I can't imagine we have a lot of money, but like I can give him a few galleons.
You realize that you are going against your parents' wishes by doing this. You will have to keep this a secret unless you choose to tell them, which you don't know how to react.
I don't like keeping things from my parents.
To skip ahead a bit, you access your account quite easily. You are gifted a galleon because you won't stop pestering your father.
Excellent work.
I don't know what the galleon is, but I have a galleon.
Kid to kid.
Franz accesses his money and gets from amount. your father gets enough to pay off the mortgage of your flat.
Hey, it's Kroner.
And then Jenny, you get enough money that you believe may be all right with Briar. How much money would that be, Jenny? I mean, Aaron. I mean, fuck.
God, you know, honestly.
Jaren.
Probably just like 3 galleons.
You give him 3 galleons.
Just like 3 galleons?
Which is the equivalent of the wizarding.
He has nothing.
The wizarding equivalent of about $100.
Oh, is it? Oof, okay.
Per galleon.
Oh, really?
Per galleon.
Okay, 2 then. 2, I think. 2.
He steals a third one under your nose.
I don't want to get in trouble, but like, he's poor.
You give him 2 galleons.
I'm probably going to get in so much trouble for this, but oh well.
And he looks at the gold. He looks up at you. And he says, are you sure?
Yeah.
I will pay you back.
Okay.
When we figure this all out. The gold's got to be somewhere.
Briar
Kane will pocket the 2 gold pieces that you've given him. That mean a great deal in this wizarding world. And the 5 of you, well, one of you gets left behind. The 4 of you leave, leaving behind your father. And...
Hello, father.
Sorry.
And both of you receive 50 XP.
Oh. I'm at level 6. What's the next? Is it 10?
11,000.
Okay,
11,000.
Erevin-chousand. That reminds me of the show Wonder-chousand. Very, very obscure reference for this one recording, but I'm throwing it out there. Wonder-chousand? You're freaking hilarious.
All right.
Great. There you go.
Is that 50, you said? 50. My finger remembered that, but my brain didn't. sounds like other things. all right.
I'm so sorry. I'm so sorry. Oh, Jenny, I'm so sorry. All right.
Are you sorry?
Briar will not follow you.
All right.
To the ice cream parlor. Do you go to the ice cream parlor? Do you go to the apothecary?
I go to the ice cream parlor when Aaron wants to go to the ice cream parlor.
Okay. Well,
if that's the next stop, then that's the next stop.
Right. I just remember that this is a magical world, so I could probably get a to-go drink container that's not going to melt. Never melt ice or something, and then it'll just stay that way. So we're good. Yeah.
Darling, I know that we're in a wizarding world, but at the same time, there are limits to our miracles.
Damn it.
I think we're going to summon ice cream. Ice creamio. Done.
Ice. ice cream, all food cannot just be created. That's one of the wizarding laws. Like, they cannot be created out of nothing, because that's not how magic works.
Well, we best go to the apothecary first, then.
So you know what?
Get some Himalayan salts.
Magic is stupid. Can't create food, but I can create fireballs.
Makes some guy fall in love with my ugly face, but yeah, not me.
Sorry. I like how I agreed at first. I was like, oh, wait. I should have said, yeah. Yeah, oh, I mean.
I was thinking about, you know, who's mum?
Dad B?
Oh, no.
I'm waiting for leadership.
Anyway.
Where are we going?
We're going to the apothecary, I think.
Really?
Apothecary. Ding, 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 ding.
Apothecary.
As the bell rings, as the door hits it, and you're like, ah, loud, but not really. And you enter, and you're instantly hit with the smells of flowers.
John, don't eat anything in here, please. Good boy.
And he finds a catnip tree.
Oof. Oh, I'll buy you one of these.
That'll be one canut, miss.
I give one canut to
you. Thank you. I meant two.
I give two nuts to Fry.
Thank you.
Fine proprietor.
I was just kidding. He was one nut. Here, take it back.
For God's sake. It's a tip. Is tipping allowed in Wizarding World?
It's a two nut tip. Anyway.
You just tipped one of our kind of friends $200 freaking dollars.
He has nothing to his name.
It's true.
That was most
actually,
of
Actually, take a good point for that.
Oh my God.
That's one good... Plus, I think my character thinks he's cute or something. Plus one good.
As soon as you enter the apothecary, the person behind the counter says, about time. Jeez.
Had some stuff to do.
We've had your satchel here for you for weeks.
Thank you. As you know, Hogwarts was closed, so I wasn't able to receive the package, and... I was hanging out with my friend Franz.
We did not even bother sending it to you because you weren't at school. We thought you would come pick it up, Gregory.
Shopkeeper. If I remember his name.
It's Anne.
His name is Anne.
No. She. Her name is Anne.
Anne Rand.
They are Anne.
My God.
Alright, Anne.
I give John his catnip.
I am very grateful for the satchel. Thank you so much for holding on to it for me. There we go. That's the words I was looking for.
On which holding of it on is me for you.
You think. I rolled a 7 for some reason, and I don't think that was for anything. I haven't rolled over 10 yet.
The 7 means that you walked up to the counter without tripping, and she's like, good job. Anyway,
great job.
She hands you a decently thick satchel.
Oh, thick.
Made of dark gray leather. And she's like, enjoy your beginner kit that you've ordered no fewer than 6 times. Seriously. How many potions do you have to burn through before you're satisfied? You freak.
You freak. Is there like an advanced set?
Yeah. It's 2 galleons. But yeah. If only one of your friends could spot you 2 galleons, you know?
That's a good one.
That's my immediate thought when you said 2 galleons. I was like, oh, if only Briar Kane was here.
You're not poor. You've got your dad right there.
Who just paid off his mortgage.
I'm going to get in a lot of trouble anyway for
that.
I
should throw him a congratulatory party. Or maybe I should make him a celebratory cake. Or like, you know,
wow. A person sidles up next to you, doesn't really look at you, and talks to Anne and says, hi. We'll take 13 more pounds of the...
Pounds?
Revival herb. If you know what I mean.
Do you mean weed?
Gregory, you will look over...
Oh, yeah.
And at Seymour.
Seymour Butts.
The guy that you really look up to.
Or Seymour Hoffman.
And he's like, hi.
Sorry. Oh.
You know, social distancing is still a thing. You should probably back up because, like, you're kind of crowding me here.
What do you need 13 pounds of revival plant for?
Experiments. I heard a rumor that you found my last invention up in Ravenclaw Tower right before we had to leave. Did you like it?
Yes.
If you don't mind. And he pulls out a little notebook with a pen, and he's like, what did it feel like?
It felt wonderful. It gave me much stronger magic power. But I feel like it wasn't quite as much magic power as it could have given me.
Damn. What do you think it was missing? Any sort of tingling in your ears or any purple urine or anything that's coming out your backbone or anything like that?
Okay, so this is Jeff talking right now.
Yeah.
Out of character.
Dear God, you changed form.
I know.
This is my final form!
Dear God, you're ugly.
Oh.
Does Gregor actually know what could have been better about it?
Yes. But you're going to have to give me a potion check.
Okay, cool.
This would be a... Whatever's higher for you, willpower or magic. It'll be willpower, probably.
If I'm not mistaken, I used Specialis Revelio on it. Which should have told me the properties
of
it.
You did. You did.
So, but I still have to make this check with a bonus, or
you'll get a bonus.
Make the check at all?
I always liked this one.
Five. Plus a bonus.
I'll give you advantage on this. Because you did use the spell on it before.
Terrific. I love advantage. A six.
Damn, dude. Plus what?
What's my magic? Was it willpower or magic?
Either one that's higher.
The highest would be willpower, which is 6. So it would be 12 plus whatever bonus.
So you imagine that it's missing something to elongate the effect to make it more stable for a longer period of time. What's wrong, honey? Okay, I thought you were biting your lip like you were hurt. But you don't quite know what to recommend because Seymour's a mini celebrity to you.
Yeah.
Because he made this fucking thing. So you're like, how do I tell him that he needs to put horse hay into it? How do I tell him that?
Was it earthy enough?
I whisper to you, you know, you're pretty awesome too, you know.
Thank you.
Deep breaths.
So, first of all...
Then I go back to, like, doing whatever the heck I'm doing with John.
Watching John have a seizure from catnip. From magical catnip.
I would like to start by saying that without the effects of your potion, I don't think my friend and I and Flitwick could have brought down the hype behind.
Good show,
Why do you believe that is?
Because there were specifically two spells that I cast on the hide behind that were much more powerful than what I was expecting.
Offensive or defensive?
Both offensive.
Damn. Gregory, I'm in the middle of developing a third possible stimulant, and I need a guinea pig, I mean a fellow potioneer, to possibly... be fine with possible side effects that might occur. You seem a hardy enough person of mind and body.
I have 6 constitution.
And you seem fine with any possible harm that might come to your Swedish visage. So I would like to hire you as my assistant.
I am so down as long as I get 1 pound of the revival plant.
I get 14 pounds in the revival plant, please.
Sick.
I need 13.
Is that, like, revival plant?
You're all right.
Oh,
yeah. Is that code for drugs?
Anne's like, did you have some of the catnip?
That's pretty much what I'm getting at.
This
is a special moment for you, though. I'm trying not to ruin it.
I'm very excited right now. I am... Okay, also, I want to tell him that, yeah, it needed just a touch more horse hay, horse hair, whatever. What'd you say it was?
Horse hay.
Sorry,
horse
Cody.
Hay?
I didn't realize that was you.
Previously chewed on hay.
Possibly pulverized.
Pulverized hay.
Interesting. You know, I actually read a study that they did over in Tibet where they used Himalayan salt to help with the elongation of effects of certain possibly revival... What was it? I'm not sure where to get Himalayan salt, though. Anyway, I will be seeing you at Hogwarts when you get back.
Rayleigh's.
I will...
Oh, but you have to go to America for that.
To America! That's what they talk over there.
I don't have any more Himalayan salt.
Nope.
So I'm just kind of like...
If only someone could hit me up. Anyway, he takes his 13 pounds of rosemary with him and leaves a pound for you. He's like, enjoy your revival bush.
Oh, it's rosemary. I thought he was talking about cannabis.
You were talking about cannabis. No one else. You were talking about cannabis.
1 pound of rosemary.
She'd probably be a pothead, though.
Call Cody over.
Cody. He did come over earlier, but I didn't know it was him, so I went like, bleh, and that freaked him out, I think.
Just curious.
Like the tail. But what else would it be?
What potion are you working on?
I mean...
One that could possibly make
what else would it be?
A wizard or witch more resilient
baby.
To the curses of darkness.
Baby.
That sounds extremely beneficial.
Yeah, all those spells.
In the right hands, yes.
I'm not supposed to use back yet.
However, so far it has only poisoned 3 of my dogs.
Oh, God.
But...
Excuse me! Be more careful.
That is what I call my friends.
Okay.
It's not. That was a lie. I just lied to her.
I've always
too celebratory for lying.
Straightforwardness.
God, Gregory's probably so pissed at her right now.
You're a terrible human being. Shut up.
Is the rosemary part of it?
What? Oh yes.
Interesting. You called it a revival plant. Rosemary. Is there some type of like a bringing back someone who's unconscious.
Oh, true.
I mean, yes, I created a revival potion back when I was in 4th year, but that's not what I'm doing with this. I believe that the ingredients that I have to use this particular 3rd stimulant are so intense that they will naturally knock you the fuck out. So the revival power of rosemary is meant to keep you awake.
Oh, stimulants, eh?
Could you possibly tell me what the ingredients are in the Seymour Revive?
There are too many ears here. I will tell you what Hogwarts.
Okay.
And Anne actually is like, yeah, what are they? Seymour! Oh, God.
Ugh, what have you done?
Lost him again.
Also, I meant to write you a thank you note for taking one of the potions without... asking. Sorry, it was kind of a busy night.
You actually helped me out because you ended up being a test subject against my permission. However, you survived, and that is the best that I could hope for. And you ended up being the prime example because something good happened. Not more pustules.
Pustules.
As I just, like, pop a pustule.
Say, one, like, appears in the back, in the center of your back.
Yeah.
Oh, God.
Globules. Give me some of your globules.
Well, I would like to, so what are the contents of the beginner's kit? So I can write them down.
So, I will say there are going to be 3 uses of each of what I'm saying. Are you ready to type?
Yeah.
Cactus. Passion fruit.
Delicious.
Lavender.
My favorite smell.
Foxtail. Jazzberries. Salamander scales. Doxy eggs.
Doxy?
Doxy. D-O-X-Y.
Got it.
Doxy eggs.
They're ugly.
And then, Neasel hair. And what was the last one? There's a flower. Amaranth. Amaranth petals.
Oh, that was a question on Ellen's Game of Games. What color is amaranth?
Purple.
I had no idea.
Three uses of each.
Oh, cinnamon. I'm sorry. There was cinnamon, too. Cinnamon sticks.
Cinnamon sticks.
Well, this isn't a very good picture.
Excellent. Thank you very much. I would like to inquire on the price of the intermediate set. Or the advanced set. Like, whatever the next one is.
Advanced set is two galleons. The intermediate is 4 sickles.
That's a lot.
Not that much. 4 sickles is like a third of a galleon?
You have it on your sheet. Would you mind checking?
17 sickles in a gallon. Galleon.
So 4 sickles wouldn't be too much. It's less than a quarter.
Mr. Mathikins.
Yeah, I want it.
You get an intermediate student level.
So these are 13 sickles. S-I-C-K-L-E-S?
Yes.
Cool.
S-I-C-K-L-E.
Sickle mouse. Donald Duck.
All right. What does that
have? So for the intermediate, spoilers, I have not written it down. Okay. However, what I'm going to say is that for this time period, if you're wanting to make a certain thing, we will then roll chance as to whether or not you can actually make it with the things in the intermediate. That's how I'll balance it.
Got it.
I'll write it down later.
I actually like that. I'm hoping that I can find some mud, some nern root, and some bay leaves in it.
There's some outside.
Rayleighs.
The mud, that is. nern root, there would be nern root in there. And then bay leaves?
Yeah.
Mm-hmm. I don't have dice? What the fuck?
Tommy.
Wow. While you're doing that, I'm just going to say I collect mud outside.
Oh my god. Your dad's going to be just like,
You meet your father and...
I collect three uses of mud.
And Franz outside, and he's like,
"We don't have a
lot." What are you doing?
Collecting mud. Shut up.
I didn't tell you.
How much nern root would be in there?
You definitely find like 6 bay leaves. Nern root. There would be 4 to 5 uses.
Bay leaves. You said 6.
Yes.
Times 6, and then you said 4 to 5. For nern root, and I got 3 muds. Boy, my character sheet is getting long.
Yeah, that's a lot of shit.
Thanks.
But
yeah.
You are the potion master.
Because now I can make Seymour serum eventually.
How many sickles in a galleon? Sorry.
17.
17. So you have 13 sickles left. Yeah.
Mm-hmm.
Okay.
Seymour serum, yes. Yes, chef.
I'm going to put in my inventory like half a pouch worth of student level apothecary set. Because
mm-hmm.
I already found some stuff. It would be like half or whatever. I would put
stuff.
Yeah.
These soundtracks are so good.
Mm-hmm.
Student level apothecary satchel. I'm going to put in parentheses with various unidentified items.
Oh, my lordy, lordy.
With various unidentified ingredients.
UFOs.
Sorry, this is...
UFIs.
This is taking a long time, and I am sorry.
No, it's all right.
I have it all now.
We're listening to the music. John's getting high with the cat crack.
How many uses of rosemary would be a pound, would you say?
Like 10.
Okay. So I have it all in the same, like, metric. Rosemary x 10. All right. Beautiful.
All right.
Excuse me, sorry.
I'm going to push you out the door to the ice cream parlor.
Okay.
Yes, time for ice cream.
It is now mid-afternoon, and you're hungry. And you want food. And what they're selling at the moment is their new featured salted honeycomb dark chocolate ice cream. There is Bertie Bott's flavor, where they got the actual syrup inside Bertie Bott's, which does not decide what flavor it is until the moment it's made into a bean. And so when you scoop it, you have no idea what you're going to have. Is it grass? Is it salmon? Who the fuck knows?
What the fuck? That's great.
And you also get strawberry, mango, peanut butter, pistachio, vanilla.
Awesome.
I would definitely like some strawberry and vanilla ice cream.
She pushes it towards you and says, "That'll be your galleon." Mm? I'm just kidding.
Two galleons.
$100 for ice cream.
12 knots.
Alright, how many nuts in a sickle?
29 knots in a sickle. So you'll have 17 knots.
That's what she said.
13 sickles.
12.
Darling!
Oh! Do you have tuna flavor?
You can try your
for the
bet
cat.
In the Bertie Bott's flavor. We don't know until we scoop
Excellent.
It.
Okay, so that's just so intriguing to me. I'll do a scoop of that. Bertie Bott's flavor thing. And one scoop of the special flavor with the salt and thing.
It's pretty thick.
That's what she said. Excellent, thank you. That'll be all. Wait, does Franson want ice cream?
I'm sharing my strawberry vanilla with him.
Does your father or your father need some for home?
Yeah, but I'll pick it up on the way out.
You know our ice cream never melts, right?
Oh, no, it didn't. All right, excellent. What the heck flavors my... Jenny wonders what the... I didn't even ask my dads what flavor they wanted. A rude ass kid.
Remember that we're gay, so we hate vanilla.
Get the rainbow color.
Rainbow sherbet. Soap.
Yeah, fruity pebbles.
Can I get the fruity pebble mix in, please?
Oh, gosh, she probably knows what my dad's like.
I do. I keep it for them back here.
Thank you.
Here's the Lucky Charms flavor.
Yum. Cool. Thank you. How much will that be?
That'll be one sickle.
There's Heart Stars and horseshoes in there.
And the blue moon.
And for you, handsome lug, she says to your dad.
Handsome lug.
He says, oh, no, thank you. I'm on keto.
Lucky for you, we have.
They could probably do that, but my taste... Ugh.
You guys sit outside.
It would just be sugar-free ice cream. Let's not overcomplicate things.
In the wonderful, sunny afternoon of Diagon Alley. And it's gorgeous out here. You see some of your classmates walking by as you are devouring your ice cream.
What flavor did John get after all the Bertie Bott's one?
Oh, right. 1 second.
So excited about that.
Fuck.
You have no idea.
Jumanji rules.
That's right.
He did not get tuna. He got spinach tripe.
Oh, no! Well, tripe is probably meaty. Do you like that? Well, I can't have
but
chocolate.
But he's so high that he has the munchies that he's like, that's fine. I mean, meh.
Good.
I mean, meh.
I was kind of expecting you to be like, roll the dice. You got metal. Metal flavored ice cream.
A guitar comes out.
You've got ass earwax flavor.
Yes. Earwax.
I would like you guys to take a nice, healthy 75 XP.
Wow.
And this wraps up the end of the Diagon Alley section, unless you want to do anything else before we fast forward.
That was fun.
Yeah, I want to find some Himalayan salt. Do I remember where I got that?
you had it imported.
Oh.
Damn it.
I make sure that I go home before I go back to Hogwarts, and I make another order for some Himalayan salt.
Jesus.
But instead of being delivered to home, I have it delivered to Hogwarts after it reopens.
You know that it cost you 19 canuts before.
Agreeable. But I want... Because that was only like 3 uses worth, I think.
Yeah. Well, but you had been using the bag before that point. But yeah, because I gave it to you as a freebie. So yeah. But it comes in a little pouch with 6 uses.
6. Seymour might want more than that.
I do.
I'm going to purchase 12 uses of Himalayan salt for a total of 38 canuts.
Or a sickle and 9 canuts.
A sickle and 9 canuts.
Yes, that's what I just said.
That was right, I have enough nuts to make
the money
a sickle.
System in this game, or this universe, drives me absolutely bananas.
I do love it how Hagrid describes it as easy enough to remember.
I do
and
too.
You're like, no.
Yeah, I like how it's odd amounts. I like that. I wonder if she did that to be annoying.
So odd.
Prime 100%. Numbers.
She's of course
well,
she did.
She is pretty odd, and also genders. Never mind.
The first session, there's like 10 minutes in, and you're like, oh, I was hoping we would avoid that.
I was.
I will put in parentheses in my inventory, incoming supply crate. Of
loadout drop
Himalayan salt Tibetan Tibetan that doesn't look right Tibetan
it's an
Tibetan thank you. Incoming supply crate of Himalayan salt.
Tibet. 6 uses. 12 uses. 12 uses. Yes.
Alright. Well, ready to go back to school. Hopefully it's free of hide-behinds.
And also free of behindy-hides.
Sounds dirty.
I was gonna say I slap Franz's butt when I say that. Behindy-hinds.
Yes.
I don't want to send the wrong message.
Mr. Wolstenholme. Is that you, sir?
Is he talking to me or my dad?
And at once you look up and you're just like, yes. Oh, it's from my father. And your father is suddenly shaking hands with somebody and you look up through the afternoon sun and you're like, who's that, dad?
Is that the goat fucker I'm a fool?
But no. It's Sean Thornwood.
Oh.
The Gryffindor boy, who's the prefect. Mm-hmm. And he's shaking your father's hand. He's like, sir, my mother has said very much about you. And I'm so glad that you moved to this country. Because you... are such an influence in the Department of Mysteries, I cannot tell you.
Ooh. Department.
This is when I learn what my dad does for a living.
I know.
And your father looks over at you and says, I was going to tell you one day. I swear. Mr. Thornwood, you're very tall. You're 6'2". I was going to tell my son one day, but you just ruined the surprise.
I imagine I'm like licking this ice cream cone and like the scoop just like falls off like
Yes. Sean looks over at you and is like, hi.
Sean.
Did you think about what I said?
A lot has happened and it's been 3 weeks' time since Hogwarts. I'm so sorry.
I do hope that we can socialize more at Hogwarts. We,
Me too.
We kind of need to stick together, you and I.
I was attacked by two different hide behinds.
Yes, I know. You need like a buddy system of some sort. Like you keep finding trouble.
Join us.
And I'm not sure why.
Join us.
I would love to hang out sometime. That would be great. I have to go get going. Your cat seems to be in a bit of a fit. Like I tell you. And Sean...
catnip.
In all seriousness, is actually like looking at Sean like...
Oh.
I don't think that's good.
And Sean's like... I once had a neasel, and if you fed them catnip, it's actually meant for regular cats. It doesn't sit well.
Isn't there
neasel nip? Knee nip.
Either that...
Or neep.
Or he doesn't trust you.
I appreciate your candor. Anyway, I'll get going. I'll see you both at school. And he hosts his bag higher up on his shoulder and he's like, ta.
Ta-ta.
Give me cunning checks, both of you, since now you're suspicious of him.
John is, even though he's high, I still trust him. 10. Excuse
eight.
Me. I farted.
I didn't fart, but I got an 8.
So sorry.
What did you roll?
10.
Neither of you noticed anything.
It's okay.
Well, John.
Does Franz notice anything?
Nope.
That's fair. I bid farewell to Sean, and I tell him that I will specifically sit at the Gryffindor table. Sorry, Franz. Opening day, so I can catch up with you, okay?
Grand. I'll save a sausage for you.
I did two.
Ooh.
Because, you know, you're 6'2".
Someone of your stature. Thank you. I am 6'2". Oh, no, I meant... Oh, shit.
I'm flustered now. I just had a very intriguing theory run through my head.
Voice it with your classmate.
I don't want to say it out loud, but Jeff can say it.
Oh, yeah, that's what I mean.
It's a little meta, though.
Okay.
For me to just talk about it, but alright. I think that the Polyjuice Potion for Briar Kane, was good enough to be passed through Gringotts and through their security checks to withdraw everything out of actual Briar Kane's account and close it and leave. And what happened today... So the people that we've come across today happens to be a very, very good potioner. And it's perhaps possible, not necessarily Seymour, but maybe affiliated with Seymour, was the one who went in and took Briar Kane's money.
Yep. I was wondering about that, but I didn't want to, like, rock the boat about your buddy Seymour.
Darling, is that you?
Johnson!
Darling!
Oh, no.
I'm not here suspiciously at all.
Oh, no,
I was
darling.
Just overhearing your conversation with Sean.
You would.
I would, and I did, because I'm a world-class gossip.
Do you guys have any milk? I just want to kick it some milk to wash it down.
Feck.
One moment, please.
Sorry, boy.
Some cow's milk.
I would like some homogenized cow pus, please.
There's water over here. You all right there, buddy? What's wrong?
I've had minor allergies.
Oh,
the entire time I've been here. And I had a really dense cake, which was freaking delicious, by the way.
It is. It's really good.
But it just... keeps getting built up in my throat because I haven't washed it down.
Can I have some water, please, while you're up?
Yes.
There's some over here, but I don't know if it's contaminated or not.
That's Cameron's water.
Then probably not, but... flat.
Was that flavored milk?
That is lactose-free milk.
Ah.
Oh. Well, that's a good thing to have.
It is clover lactose-free milk. Anyway.
Sorry to interrupt.
Your father has just announced, or been forced to reveal, that he works for the Department of Mysteries.
Hmm.
What do you do with that?
I'm going to hold on to it. I'm going to talk to him about it when we're not in the public.
You're home. I'm kidding.
I was like,
as you guys depart from each other after ice cream, and now's your last chance to tell me that you want to stay in Diagon Alley for any reason.
No, I just gossiped with Chauncey for a little bit.
Alright. He's like, you know, I heard that Sean Thornberry is... Anyway, you escort Erin to the bonfire, which is the flu powder network, leading home for her. And you wave goodbye to her as she says, 1, 2, 3, Fake Street! And she walks into the fire.
Fake Street.
And it burns emerald green. And Erin McClagan is gone. Erin Lucas is gone.
Right, I was like, wait, what? It's not...
Erin Dulaugenhary is gone.
Right.
You are now alone with your father and Franz. Do you want to wait till proper? Because this is a story bit, so it is a bit of a thing for you to actually bite onto or not.
You know, 123 Fake Street is a very peculiar address. What do you think about Dad?
I think you're acting a bit peculiar, son.
It's okay that Franz is here for us to talk about your job. He knows our family inside out.
Yes.
He may as well know.
Go on.
I'm curious as to how long you've been working in the Department of Mysteries. And also, I'm okay with the fact that you kept it secret for so long. I imagine that you have a lot of confidential information.
You know, you have proven to be very mature and resourceful during your time at Hogwarts, especially during this last year. I'm not going to be the type of father to say you must be this type of person when you come of age, because I was never raised that way. I don't believe that people should. Franz, neither should you. So, however, I think that it would be wise to know what is present in the Department of Mysteries to a point, just to know what your options are, because the nature of the Department of Mysteries is such a secret that people tend to believe that we deal in very dark mischief.
Which, of course, you do.
Not what you might believe.
What can you tell me?
I can tell you that the Department of Mysteries is a place in which we explore the baser aspects of our world. Time. Death. The future. Love. The building blocks in which we create day by day. What we base our lives around. We study why these things exist and how they control us and how we can control it. I am pleased to say that I have just recently been promoted. We paid off the house. Recently been promoted to a Time Turner animator.
Wow.
And it's a big deal for me and your mother. So...
Time Turner?
Yes.
Doesn't that mean you are able to go in the past?
I can return to the day in which we used to call you Pillow. Yes.
Mm. Have you?
No.
Because of the dangers behind it?
That, of course, but also because if I went back that far, I would have to relive all the days leading back up to now.
Oh.
I believe. If I knew that my death were coming, say that if I was falling ill from a deathly illness, I would use a time turner to return to some sort of happy memory of all of us when you were younger and become one with that time. Don't tell your mother I said that.
Could you just, like, keep going back in time?
Yes.
Like, every time you're about to die?
But then there would be multiple instances. Ah, I see what you're saying. There is no way to stop death. So I, at my age now, would proceed back in time to the moment in which I pre-existed, but now there would be two of me in that moment.
Got it. Very interesting. Do you think that your past self would understand an older self coming into the past?
There have been documented wizards and witches that have tried to talk to themselves. The very strange thing is that such records never come to light.
That's a bad idea.
We have no proven documented instances of what truly happens, but we know that either all of them or most of them either do not return or end up dead.
Do you think that with time turners existing, the department should have a training course on how to act when a future version of themselves comes back in the past to meet themselves? I think it's so deep right now.
That could actually be a thing. Perhaps.
Cool. Anyway, does it bother you that I wish to pursue culinary arts?
No.
It's a good dad.
Very good dad.
I know I'm not here right now. I'm just offering little inputs because, you know, I'm part of the game.
Now, are you two going to make out or?
No.
Right. Rock on, as the kids say. Yeah.
Franz, what do you think?
I am very curious about the death room. Mm. And your father says, we don't talk about it.
Oh, shit. The unspeakables.
He is unwilling to go on.
I have one more question for you, Dad. Well, I have more questions, but one that I wish to ask immediately. Is the time turner,
you mean this?
Is it affixed to you?
No.
And you only?
No.
Or could someone potentially take it and use it for harm?
There is no attachment. It is as if someone could cast Expelliarmus on my wand and they could use my wand. This is not tied to me whatsoever. I am simply one of the constructors.
I imagine you are keeping it very well hidden.
Well, it literally just showed it to you.
It's just
but
the three
yes.
of us, though. Okay. I just don't want anything bad to happen to you. That type of power, as you know, is probably very, very dangerous.
Yes.
Does Mom know about your promotion and your responsibilities?
Yes.
Does Mother know?
Why were you given... Sorry, I have more questions now. Why were you given a time-turner... You said a time-turner animagus?
Animator.
Animator. So, being an animator, why were you given the time-turner?
In order to experiment if I saw fit, because this is a new model.
What's your day-to-day life like?
Very normal. I have yet to use this model.
Is it like an office job? And you sit back and take notes and theorize about what-ifs and could-bes?
Of sorts. The actual process of distilling time itself is surprisingly boring. We do have a rumor that there have been several employees that have worked with us that we now no longer remember.
Boy, I would really like to go back in time and relive my first experience eating baklava for the first time.
Well, you would too. So, no. Unless you want to relive 13 years of your life.
Yes. Well. I'm about done here. Thank you for telling me. Congratulations on the mortgage. I'll bake you a celebratory cake within this last week. And...
What flavor?
And they may never... Like,
and they may never know! You're such a little cutie boy! Oh, Rupert.
What's your favorite cake, Papa?
Paprika and corn.
Ugh.
What's weird?
Is this like mayonnaise cake then? Mm.
Potato and mayonnaise.
Ooh, they like those fancy princess cakes there.
The princess cakes? Like the dome cake with the
yes.
Barbie stabbed in the middle?
Yeah, yeah.
Are you kidding me?
Maybe not the Barbie, but like all the pretty
really?
Icing and stuff, yeah.
I did not know that. Does it consist of every flavor? All right.
George swears he got a bogey flavor.
You guys, you have to fast forward. Pretty hard and fast.
Mm.
All the way to 5 days from now.
Alexa.
5 days from now, in which you find yourself suddenly back on the Hogwarts Express. And you are chugging along the dark road. Road? Train track. Towards Hogwarts.
Is the trolley lady come by yet?
Yes. I only have licorice wands. Everyone else ate everything.
Red or black?
Black.
I'll take black. Black licorice is delicious.
Are we in the same cabinet? Because I must get away from as far away from you as possible. Oh wait, maybe Aaron likes black licorice though. No, I can't even smell it without wanting to throw up.
I'm so sorry.
Oh, it's bad.
I don't do well with licorice either, actually.
Have I ever told that story? I had a coworker at BevMo that had a hand sanitizer that smelled like anise and was using it.
That smelled like anise?
Anise, yeah. It's,
oh,
yeah.
I thought you were trying to say anus, like,
no.
Finally.
Well, that too. Oh, God. And I almost threw up.
Yeah.
I'm so sorry. I'm sorry.
Katie used to apparently have a plant in her backyard that smelled just like licorice. And she's like, I would rub it in my hands. It was amazing. And I'm like, and then you would die, right? You would die of like hunger, but also not because you would like want to throw up.
Some people like it.
Yeah, I would. I'm right there with Katie, honestly. I would love that.
Anyway.
I will eat a gigantic black licorice rope right in front of both of you right now if I could.
Maybe Aaron's not that opposed to it.
You're like, no.
Ew.
Is there actual black licorice in there?
I don't want to make
Jenny Vom.
How dare it touch the other candy?
The audacity of this licorice. Oh, just regular licorice?
There's a Twizzler. Because well, Aiden has too much candy.
Well, thank you. This isn't black licorice, though.
Yeah, well, I do what I can, buddy.
Good riddance, you loony.
Honey.
What?
Have a nerd's rope.
No, I just
Okay.
Oh, I thought you were going to throw it, so I, like, shrank back a little bit. Those are super good.
You guys are chugged along. The castle's in the distance. You hear the wind pitter-patter against the glass, realizing you guys are quickly entering wintertime. It is quite cold, and as you see the lake, as you descend down the stairs from the train, the lake is all hither and thither with water and plippity-ploppity all over the placey-plossy. And you go into the Karagiagis, and you go trotting up the hillsies all the way up to the castle gatesies, and they say, "Welcome back to Hogwarts Altsies!" Alright, we thought she'd be more excited. Alright then. Come on in.
Sorry.
You feckers. Come have Halloween feast. Because it's October 31st.
Oh, the floating pumpkins.
You return to Hogwarts Castle on New Hallows Eve.
This is the problem, the
soundtracks these days. They all sound like,
Was that Jeff?
Sorry.
That's the problem with epic music. It all sounds like the same epic music. Avengers had to stand out because but then, like, sorry.
Oh, fine. So I made the argument.
You
it's
said
recorded.
You wouldn't play it. I'm not playing it.
Yeah, well, you know what? This is Halloween. It has a very distinct melody line, okay? So.
You guys walk all
it
down the
like
corridors.
John Williams does a good job.
You get to the main hall. You sit down
Wait,
at your
Williams.
Tables.
You didn't
this is Halloween? Oh, I thought we were talking about...
So sorry. You're right, my bad.
It's okay.
No, I don't know who did this, but it was good shit.
What, for Nightmare Before Christmas? It was Danny Elfman.
Oh!
It was the Elfman.
Oh.
Really?
Oh, I didn't know that.
For I, Jack,
I
the pumpkin
would like to watch that again. It's been a while.
You well, guys, I'm going to stay at the Gryffindor table because I told Sean I would.
Give me a D20 true check.
I'll stay at my table, but I'll wave at you.
13.
Hi, friend.
You look back at Franz as you separate from him, leading
friend.
To the Gryffindor table.
Franz
and you do catch that he looks after you.
Come along, Franz.
We just spent a month together. It's okay, Franz.
You
Come
sit
along.
With Franz.
Yes.
And you start picking at the giant gummy turkey because it's Halloween. And you sit right next to Sean. And he has two large bratwursts.
Ah, a man of his word. Mm. And 6'2", mind you.
Delicious.
He slowly inserts one of the bratwursts into his mouth, staring at you all the while. And gets
I
all
cut mine in half.
And gets drizzle it in ketchup and lick it.
I don't really want ketchup on mine. I don't know what accent that was. I would dip mine in mayonnaise.
I don't want ketchup on mine. You guys are privy to a speech given to you from Dumbledore. I'm going to quiet this down.
Dumbledore comes out like, hey guys, this is Halloween.
I'm Jack the Pumpkin King.
I am.
Welcome. Welcome. Hogwarts.
Hogwarts,
you are. Did you put your name in the comments?
As he comes across the room and shakes him. Like
each student, he says, has to come up to him by the end of the night so he can shake him.
Even Snape's like,
He says to you all,
that's great.
I know this is unorthodox for such a great vacation away from Hogwarts Castle in the middle of your academic year. However, I want to thank you for your patience, your understanding, and your candor in so many vividly written owls to my office complaining about your lack of education. I would like to say classes begin promptly at 8 a.m. tomorrow morning.
So early.
To our fifth years. Mm-hmm. Please understand that this was not a decision made lightly. And as a result of this brief break, your tests will not be altered in any given way. Meaning I do hope you have been studying while you have been gone.
Of course.
Many fifth years are like, oh, he's serious.
Oh, crap. Okay.
At least one of the classes, because it's all over my house.
Now, I would like to put your minds at ease, because while you have been gone, the faculty has been searching the castle from top to bottom. Every tower, every catacomb, every dungeon and classroom has been searched thrice. There is no threat here. Ores are now on scene at every hour of the day and night. Nothing is here except for students eager to learn and teachers eager to teach.
Hmm.
The threat, however brief, was loud and threatening. And I regret
being the headmaster who sat up watching over you and almost risked your lives by not protecting you from such an invisible threat.
We got you.
You stand up. Yeah, you. Yeah. And he's like, sit down. tomorrow morning, let us work together to maintain the Hogwarts spirit and keep each other safe. But in that vein, you must know that if any of you see anything concerning, hear anything threatening, or feel not at ease with any given person, please bring it to the attention of any given teacher, namely your heads of houses or myself, immediately.
Immediately.
Now off to bed. Pip, pip.
Oh man, I am tired.
So I am having a very bad allergic reaction.
Buddy.
Don't I don't think.
Sorry. Not allergic reaction, just allergies worse. In general. I hate having it. Like it's like itchy tear ducts.
Oh.
Let's go to my camera.
Do you want a wet washcloth or something?
I mean, yeah, I'll take it. It's just I don't know if that's gonna really help. Itchy eyes are the worst. Mm-hmm. I would take literally every other.
Do you take anything for it?
Seasonal allergies over itchy eyes. I did, but I realized that my antihistamines expired.
Ew.
So.
They may never.
They may never.
George swears I got a bogey flavor that month.
That grass one was something else. I had that as a kid. How do I know what grass tastes like? Well, it was
a joke box of jelly beans. One of them had a black one in it and it was skunk flavored.
Mm-mm.
And it was so bad.
That's disgusting.
It's probably the worst thing I put in my mouth ever. Thank you so much.
How do they even make that?
I don't know, essence of skunk?
How?
They attempted to make cheese flavored jelly
beans. Oh, yeah.
And it just came out horribly wrong.
Oh.
So they decided, you know what, we'll just recycle that and make it the vomit flavor.
Ew.
That's so bad.
I never tried that one. I was a.
Cheese flavored.
Not brave enough for that.
Do go on. Sorry. I know, it's a little weird because I'm out of commission right now.
Alright. When you awaken tomorrow.
Yeah?
I know it's been a bit of a lackluster session.
No,
getting back
no,
into
that's
things,
not.
But. I'm
we had a whole lot to cover over the.
Not mine. I'm having fun.
When you all waken up in the morning, you have classes bright and early, like instantly, like right now. Bang, right now.
All right.
It's not Professor Binns, that would suck.
No. It's Professor Janus.
Oh,
because you have Defense Against the Dark Arts together bright and early in the morning. And you get into Defense Against the Dark Arts class, sit down, and your foot hurts because Franz took you to a trampoline park and you fell wrong. And you have a hard time standing. And you, and people are looking at you weird, like, why did you get hurt so bad? What the hell? And then, suddenly, it's like fireworks go off inside the classroom. And all of you are, like, screaming, and they're blinded, and you're like, what the hell? Why? Ah! And then suddenly, Professor Janus is at the front going, surprised you, didn't I?
Oh my god, this guy. Yeah. That
yeah.
you did, sir.
Now.
That you did.
Why? Why did you not stop me?
It's early. How many dark arts happen at 8 in the morning?
Dark arts occur at every given minute of every single day. You are fools for putting your wands down at a time like this. Did you not hear Dumbledore's speech last night? He said there was ample threat in this castle, and you must be ready for anything at all.
That's not what he said.
He said that he checked everything thrice.
That is not what I heard. We are staying by what I said.
All right. Sorry.
Now.
I'm right. You're wrong.
I'm right. You're wrong. Shut up.
I am the authority. Yeah.
Now. It is my job to prepare you for what is out there in the dark. It is my job to prepare you for the dark arts that may come your way, for the war that you may fight in. It is my job to teach you the defensive spells to keep you and your friends safe. It is my job to teach you a warrior's heart, so you may fight against the darkness.
Very nice.
Hear laughter in the back. I will not allow laughter.
The crowd talking to you.
Right now. Amazing.
I ate my grandma.
She was
oh my god. Pick an eye. Just pick one. Pick one. Alright. He says. Oh, Jeff, I'm sorry.
Just pick one.
Pick one. Pick one.
Pick one.
He says.
Shiny.
Now, pop quiz.
Oh, excellent.
I love pop quizzes.
What spell is used to lock a door?
I know unlock at the moment.
Of course you know unlock. Oh, you were taught in first year through the basic book of spells, level 1. How do you lock a door? Yes.
Oh wait, Alohomora is unlocking a door. Locking a door is...
Nope.
Alaramola.
Franz gingerly raises his hand.
Oh, Franz.
And Janus says, yes, sweet lad. And Franz will say, Caloportus, I believe.
Oh, Caloportus, yes.
And Janus will say, yes. 10 points to Hufflepuff. Well done.
Yes!
Now,
I thought I did.
What can you do to make your text illegible? What spell makes your text turn into tongues, as it were?
Obscura.
That is possibly one way, but indirect.
Alright, I also didn't raise my hand. It's been a long time since I've been in school.
A Slytherin raises his hand and said, illegibilis. Yes. Well done.
Illegibilis.
10 points to Slytherin. Now, what does one do to fix what is broken that cannot be organic? For one's heart cannot be broken and then fixed by this spell.
Reparo?
20 points to Gryffindor. Well done. Well done. Very, very well done.
Sorry,
yes.
Mr. Janus. Do you have any eye drops?
Oh, Jeff. I'm sorry, dude.
There's always something wrong with either one of us.
There really is. It's kind of sad.
What do you want to do? Do you want to call it? Do you want?
No, don't call it. Don't call it. I'm actually enjoying myself. Despite this.
Yeah, sure.
But what do you need? Do you want more water on the towel? Do you want to step outside? What do you need?
If you have eye drops, that'd be good.
I don't think we do.
If not, I'll just take like a Kleenex. And I'll keep doing the washcloth bit. It helps a lot, actually. Thank you for the washcloth.
Cameron's idea was cold water. Here's a Kleenex.
Thank you. Yeah, the cold water honestly helps a lot.
Alright. He wants to teach you something.
Ooh!
He wants
Sorry.
to teach you One moment.
He wants to teach us legilimens. What?
Legilimens.
Oh, yes. The little spell Crucio.
Crucio!
Oh, my gosh.
What happened?
Okay.
Okay. No caps.
Jeff, do you know Salvo Hexiam?
Yes.
Okay, that's what I thought.
You know, that's a very useful spell.
Yeah, of course it's a very useful spell.
It's a rumor that I've heard, but yeah, apparently it's a really good spell. Yeah, he wants to teach you Reducto. Now, Reducto.
Wait, it makes
things explode. Great spell.
Reducto is one of my favorites because it is well-rounded. You may use it on organic matter as well as inanimate objects. You may burst through a door that has been locked from behind. You may cast through a person's face. It is one of my favorites because you can use it in so many different situations. Don't you agree?
Yes.
You don't have to agree because I'm right, you're wrong. Shut up. Now, I want all of you to stand up.
Is this Tommy as a professor? Because I think it is. Sometimes. Just a little bit. Just a little bit. Just not for kids, like for college age.
He waves his wand and the desks all fly around the room.
Mm.
And he says, I want you to practice the wand movement. Sing down. Flick up. West, east, straight. Again, it is down. Up. West, east, straight.
That's like crossing yourself.
Gregory, you're not doing it. I'm kidding.
I'm not. Doing it in my head right now, Professor. I'm so sorry.
It's all right. You're fine, I think. Do you think it was the lemons?
What?
Do you think it was the lemons that caused it? In the cake?
No. My eyes are stupid.
Oh.
I get it from indoor stuff. But
yeah.
I'm taking medicine
could
at
be,
the moment.
It could be Cody for all I know.
I'm actually allergic
it's just,
to cats.
It's all kinds of things, dude.
I'm allergic to my own cat.
Yeah.
I'm sorry, guys.
I take you the I take medicine for it.
I need you all to give me magic checks to see if you can retain the magical movements needed to learn Reducto.
Down, up, west, east, straight.
No! Oh my god.
10 plus 2 is 12.
See over my boobies where it went. Oh, that's easy enough. All right. Do I add anything to this?
Magic.
Magic. It's just like magic. Oh, I have 6. 4 plus 6.
Oh my.
That's not good.
10. Now, you will need to give me the willpower check that will help you maintain this spell in your mind's eye to actually allow you to feel that it is one of your spells at your disposal, in your Rolodex of abilities, that you may be in a battle and go, oh, I know, Reducto. In other words, give me a willpower roll.
Baby.
18 plus 6.
Well, I've got 6 willpower.
Jeffrey, you learn Reducto.
Reducto.
No, I don't learn Reducto.
Do you like how I did the motions?
Yes.
Okay,
you could potentially... I'm going to give you Reducto rudimentary in the sense that you know it...
Rudimentary.
Possibly for like 24 hours. And at the end of that, you will get one final check. And if you fail it, you do not learn it. Okay?
Sounds good to me.
Reducto.
Yeah, that was a bed on my part here.
It's in the spells list, yes.
Indeed, it's under Defense Against the Dark Arts. And then you go down to Greater.
Thank you. Oh, it's a Greater ability?
And it's at the top, almost to the full... Okay,
it's
I'll shut up then.
Small blue-white ball of energy towards the target, reductive blast a solid object into a fine mist, ash, or powder. Used on an enemy, can destroy clothes, armor, or cause significant damage to bone structure.
Oh, that's gnarly.
D8 plus magic bleed damage.
9 MP.
Ow.
It's a little
it's 9
expensive.
MP.
It doesn't sound like a very nice spell.
Well, that was fun. Sorry. That was to stop me from doing a weird shudder thing that I do.
I think I know what you're talking about. Yeah. You're so tired that your body shakes when you yawn.
Yeah, or it's like some weird involuntary thing, because I'm just weird. But I'm not... I don't know why I'm tired, honestly.
Did you work today?
Yes, I did.
Then yeah.
But I got decent sleep. My loud neighbors were quiet, / probably not home.
/ probably died.
God, I hate these people. I've never had loud neighbors like this before. It's really bad. And our bedrooms are like, they butt up against each other. Oh, God, kill me.
I'm so happy I just learned a new spell.
The best is having a room right next to someone else's living room where they love to have sex.
Yeah. These people shake the whole bed.
I remember...
That's awful.
I was playing, really loud, flamenco guitar at, 11:30 or midnight once when I was living in my apartment. And I didn't realize that I was literally butted right up next to somebody else's master bedroom. And the pounding that ensued, a few minutes after I started playing was so jarring. I was, really into it by then because I'd been playing for a few minutes. And then it was just, just pound, pound, pound. I was like, oh, God.
Yeah, I did that once.
I felt such a jerk.
At, 3 in the morning.
I wasn't even thinking about that.
Sometimes I yell back, too, because that's the problem. This chick, she just doesn't have another volume. It's been better since they, have, an infant now, so they have to be quiet. But she still, I swear to God, will yell to someone in the other room. The other day, it was, you want Jimmy Changos? So I yelled, yes! Usually she shuts up if I yell back for a while.
Yes! That is wonderful.
What? That's perfect. They're not very friendly people. One time he was shut up, my. He's talking to this baby. Shut the fuck up, little baby. I'm like, what the hell's happening over there? That's not how you talk to your child. Even though I can't hear your words yet. Okay.
They can feel the energy.
I called Xander a leaf blower for the first 2 years of his life.
A leaf blower?
Playing what? With a leaf blower.
I'm just kidding.
That is the most childish thing I've ever heard of.
Oh, hello, you little leaf blower. I call him something stupid every time instead of his actual name.
That's cute.
We call Aiden a bunch of things, like Little Fuego, because he's a fire sign, and Aiden means fire in Celtic.
I love it.
Ooh, I didn't know that.
Love it.
Little Fuego.
He's also Jelly Bean.
Yeah. Luke is Marshmallow, because I embarrassed him by calling out Marshmallow one day in front of school, so it just stuck.
His baby name.
How old was he, 7? And he was just like, Dad, please don't embarrass me, okay? People were walking around, I'm like, okay. And he got out of the car. I rolled down the window.
Oh, no.
Have fun at school, Marshmallow! And he's like, Dad! And a girl walked right by him, did he just call you Marshmallow? And I'm like, perfect.
Yes.
He's so young to be embarrassed
and
by
his parents. It just stuck. And
he'll never tap that later.
What's funny is that he got back in the car at the end of the day, and I'm like, so you're still mad at me? He's like, about what? And I'm like, yep. So it's
perfect.
Stuck. It's stuck.
About what?
What'd you do?
God.
All right.
Listen up.
Buttercup.
I'm so happy.
Because you learned Producto.
Yes. What class do we have?
You have a divination. She has care of magical creatures. I'm going to spoil. I'm mostly going to focus on something that happens to you.
Right now?
Yes.
Okay. How could you?
Your
eyes aren't itchy.
I am suspecting that we may want to finish earlier tonight than going, rather than go to 11 tonight.
What time is it?
It's 10.
Almost 10.
Okay. Professor Shala is quite old.
Oh, yes, excellent.
The Herodrum. So
the Herodrum?
Is this the divination?
Yes. Professor Shala.
The Herodrum.
Is gray haired, rather rickety, on her spindly chair, and she doesn't look comfortable no matter the position that you see her in, standing, sitting, lying down. Why is she lying down in a classroom? I don't know.
Dramatic.
She never seems quite settled with where she is. Divination is quite a sensitive subject because most people think that it's just a hack, and they either suspect that she's a liar or that she has deluded herself into thinking that she is a seer.
Oh.
There's actually even a rumor that Dumbledore might get rid of the subject once Professor Shala moves on away from Hogwarts.
Hmm.
But, regardless, today you're learning tarot. Tarot cards. Quite a favorite thing of me, actually. But, you're going to learn them today. And by learning, I mean to say, you're going to have your tarot cards read. Gregory.
The Seven of Itchy Eyes. Mm.
Now, we can do this in two ways. I can either get my tarot cards in real life and give you a tarot reading where you pick three random cards and we do it for your character. Or we can do dice rolls.
We'll do dice rolls. We're going to keep it simple.
Okay.
Ah, yes, you have the orange fire Salamanca. Itchy eyes. Ooh.
No. Give me a d20 willpower check.
Power check. It's kind of my jam, bro. Fucking 8 plus 6 for 14.
Look at that. You got the golden oak tree face up. Go again.
16 plus 6 for 22.
Gregory. You have the salmon bones upside down.
John goes, hmm?
Yeah. 15 plus 6 for 21.
You've got the closed door. What hides behind the door, Gregory?
Probably salmon bones and trees.
What hides behind the
antihistamines.
I see in your future quite a bit of potential to grow, to prosper, and to really grow into one's own growth.
Growth.
The bones mean that there's a fear of death and decay and withering to nothing like the fish that washed up on shore and unable to get home. There is a fear in you. And the door, the closed door, hide a darkness inside you. There is a fear
darkness.
Of something trying to get out.
No, perhaps.
But you have locked it down. Hiding away. Draw one more card. And this will be your future.
No pressure. No pressure.
I'm second guessing my love for divination right now. Ah. 12 plus 6 for 18.
You pick up the card, and it fumbles out of your fingers, and it lands sideways.
Dun dun dun. A 6.
She flips it. Oh, it's the red balloon. You're going to be fine.
Oh my, Evan.
quiz, loves.
That was so wonderfully anticlimactic.
What creatures come out of a magical fire? There are two. List them now on your paper. Turn them in to me by the end of the day.
Oh, we're in care of magical creatures.
Come on now.
Oh, we are. Okay.
The Ifrit and the Imp.
Oh, it's a salamander. And a dragon.
No. With Sarah no longer next to you to cheat off of, you're like, feck.
Hey, I'm good at this class. My character would be good at this class. Whether or not I remember things from lore is another question.
Mm-hmm.
I, Jenny.
Mm-hmm.
So, fire would be like fire elementals and
poor Jeffrey.
Fire
oh
imps.
My god.
Fire salamancas.
You get half credit because salamanders are one of the correct answers. You are overhearing other people say the word Ashwinder.
The fuck is that?
Ashwinder.
Wait, dragon's not the other answer?
No. they don't even eat fire. They just blow it. Salamanders are the lizard creatures that eat flame and are born from flame. Ashwinders are smoke spirits that are manifest out of the smoke of flue powder. And they hide away into burrows, hatch or leave their eggs behind as they blow into nothing. And their eggs light houses on fire because of how hot they are.
That's not good.
But if they are found in time and Galatius is used, they are frozen and can be really good potion material.
Oh, hey.
I'm not there.
If I had referenced my book that I brought.
Ashwinder's like one of the first things, I think.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Sick.
It's alphabetical.
It is.
It's right after Arva.
It's right next to Aubrey.
Like, doodles from Harry in here. It's pretty funny. No, I was trying to think of that. Hogwarts hasn't read this book is in here a lot, which cracks me up.
All right.
But nobody's told Hagrid.
Both of you are going to receive 100 XP, and then one more thing is going to happen, then we're going to close. All right?
One more thing.
One more thing. Tricky.
Oh, that was a good show. I miss it.
Tricky.
Mine's feeling a little better.
Good.
One more thing. All right.
You are leaving divination. You are in such a pissed off mood because it's like, that was so nice to come back to. I thought they were going to show me like prosperity and like riches or like love. But no. You're a little bit miffed because balloon. Sideways balloon. What the hell is that supposed to mean? So for the rest of class, she's like, the positions and the orientation and the time of day and the star alignment. And you're like, I don't care. Balloon. So you put away your things angrily, like by gesturing to everything. With everything that you have. And so you zip up and you look up and everyone else is kind of going down the hatch door. And you're like, okay, wait up. But then you're also alone suddenly with Professor Shala.
Uh-oh.
And she seems pissed off suddenly. Because she's making huffy sounds behind you. What do you do?
I turn around.
She's doing a tarot card reading. Alone at her table.
Are you reading your own future?
She does not look up. But she opens a second card, throws it down.
Is something amiss?
She picks up a third. Oh, hello.
Was I supposed to see that?
They're just cards.
Odd.
Excuse me?
They're just cards.
The amount of theatrics that you put into the card reading earlier suggests that you think that they are more than just cards.
Well, perhaps they're not just cards. Perhaps they really do divine the future. And if they do, the future sucks, as the kids say.
Uh-oh.
The wood fire smoke. She gestures to you, the card to you. Okay. The wood fire smoke. Hinting at an upcoming doom. The dark house, filled with secrets and potential and hidden doom.
the silent lizard filled with secrets and hinting at a silent doom.
Lots of doom.
And she pulls, doom, she puts the deck towards you and says, take the next card. Show me what my future is. Or perhaps, and you're going to take the card, perhaps it is yours.
I look at it first.
Take it. It's yours.
There is a maze in which, in the image, there is a fork in the maze that shows a wizard pointing his wand up, trying to decide which way to go. And one way shows bright light. Another shows darkness with a tentacle coming out of it. And she asks, what did you get, Gregory?
Yeah, what did you get?
I got a fork in the road.
Another turning point, a fork stuck in the road.
And so one must wonder, do you go for the easy ending? Or do you stay for the darkness?
No parents.
House. Lizard. Smoke. Have fun in your next class.
Do you tell me any of this later?
Maybe. But I'm definitely going to put all caps. House, lizard, smoke.
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 And fork in the road.
Time grabs you by the wrist to let you where to go.
I think
so. Take the wind on the
best, don't ask why. I have a clue as to what's going on.
It's not a question, but a lesson learned in time.
It's something unpredictable.
And the end is right. I hope you had the time of your life.